Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In this session, we will see the function of this TOP221-227 IC. It is a top switch 2 family. 3 terminal offline PWM switch. If you see this IC, this one is TOP224Y and it is TOP224PN. What is the difference between these two components? We will see in detail. Basically, it is a family. TOP221YN, it is 12 watt. 222YN, if we have PN, so this is YN. YN numbers will here and PN number will here. It is in dual line package, SMD or DIP. So this one, if 221Y, that is 12 watt, and here it is 9 watt. 222Y, that will 25 and 15 watt. 15 watt for universal for 85 to 265 volt range. If you will use that single input, for example 100 volt, 220 volt, plus minus 15%, at that time its power rating will this. And if we are using as a universal, at that time it will 7 watt. In our case 224, this time we are using this IC and this one is here. If you will use this IC, it is used for single supply 75 watt, universal supply 45 watt. And if you will use this IC, the same number, just only PN, it is 30 watt for single supply, 100 volt, 150 volt or 230 volt, at that time 30 watt. And here for 85 to 260 volt operation universal supply, it will provide 20 watt. Here 45 watt. So to take the same function from this IC or this IC, we need to compare the watt rating. That means in very simple ways, if anywhere this IC is used 20 watt operation and we cannot find this number, we can use this one in this place, or we can use next higher number that is available in this family. For example, I need to TOP221, it is not available. I can use 222, 223, 224, 225, 226, 227. It is a set. Or we can use anyone this IC. It is 100 kilohertz fixed frequency oscillator. It have just only 3 pins. I will not go in very deep details. Just only we will take a sketch of this circuit, this IC. If you see here in the block diagram, we have source pin and we have drain pin and we have control pin, 3 pins. The left pin, if we see here, the control pin, the leftmost pin, that is this one, the center pin, source pin, the right pin, that is drain. The similar here, if you are using this IC in the complete family, in all these numbers from 221 to 224, the DIP package is only available in these numbers, but 3 terminal device, TO220 package, we can select any one IC from these numbers. So here the first 3 pins are source pins and the right side pins, all pins are source pins, and pin number 5, that is drain, pin number 4, that is control pin. We can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 pins are ground pins and 1 pin is drive pin, that is drain pin. And this is source pin. This is control pin, pin number 4. So we can say this IC and this IC are same. 6 pins ground pins, 1 pin drain pin and control pin. From here if we see, source pin is connected to ground and it is connected to the transformer primary. Normally we apply positive voltage here. It will take positive voltage, and here is a capacitor connected here outside from this IC. When this capacitor will charge 4.7 to 5.6 volts, above 5 volt this IC will start switching. It will start to provide pulses and it will start. It will monitor the current here, how much current is flowing and how much voltage are coming from here. It is also called feedback current. It will monitor this voltage level here, which are provided from the optocoupler. So it will control the output voltage. Here is the working window. From 4.7 to 5.7 volt, this circuit will work. From the charging time, once it needs to reach at 5.7 volt to start up. After that, it will complete its switching cycle until the voltage are remained at 5.7. If any time the 5.7 volt will exceed, it will turn off its switching. If the voltage will drop from 4.7 volt, it will stop switching and it will start to charge the VCC capacitor again from its internal regulator circuit from here. When the voltage will reach at specific voltage level, at that time it will turn off its internal charging switch. At that time this pin will connect it to this auxiliary winding, the bias winding. Here is its circuit, sample circuit. Any switch from top 221 to 227, any IC can be used here. Voltage will reach to the transformer, to the drain pin, and it will charge its capacitor at initial stage. When the voltage will reach at specific level, this IC will start switching. It will switch the ground, so it will make pulses here. These pulses will drive this transformer, and this magnetic field will induce voltage in secondary and auxiliary winding. Auxiliary winding voltage will rectify and it will come to the optocoupler. When we will receive exact required voltage which we need from the output terminal, 5 volts, at that time the optocoupler will energize. It will allow to pass this voltage to this capacitor. We can say it is working as a relay, it is working as a switch. So when the voltage will reach at specific level here, this optocoupler will allow to pass the voltage to charge this capacitor at that time, because its internal charging circuit, which was charging this capacitor, now that is blocked. Now this circuit will oscillate, it will work based on this voltage. If the output voltage are increased, when it will increase, when we will remove the load, the voltage will try to increase. At that time it will control its switching. It will skip the cycles. And if the voltage are decreased, how it will decrease from 4.7 volt when we will put load? When we will put load, the voltage will try to decrease. This current will decrease. The voltage level will decrease. So this IC will become to know that I have to increase the current. So this is the process. Let's see it practically. For that purpose, I will use this three terminal device, TOP224-Y. And I will connect on the project board. I connect it here. I will connect capacitor here, 47 microfarad, 35 volt. The ground side will connect it to the center pin. Center pin is source pin. Okay, I will connect it. I will connect the capacitor in the rear side. That's much better. So we will take a space, capacitor positive terminal to pin number 1 and the ground terminal to pin number 2. At the right side pin, that is drain pin, here I will connect 1 kilo ohm resistor. Pin number 3, the right side drain pin, I will connect this 1 kilo ohm resistor. I connected 1 kilo ohm resistor to the drain pin and I will apply positive voltage to the end of this resistor. How the circuit will work? This is our IC. This is drain pin. I will connect 1 kilo ohm resistor here and I will apply positive 14 volt, positive 12 volt, whatsoever. This pin is ground. And I will connect a capacitor here, 47 micro, 35 volt. And here we will apply voltage from 1 volt to 6 volt. Let's make the circuit. First, I am connecting power here between these two pins. Here I have 14 volt. I applied 14 volt to resistor. Resistor is connected to drain. If we check voltage at the control pin, this time the IC is charging from its internal circuit and it is reached up to 3.23 volt. Because this time these voltage are low voltage because we are testing the IC. Now I will use my this small voltage regulator circuit variable supply and I will take the ground voltage from here and the positive voltage to this circuit and I will take output of this circuit ground to ground and I will inject this voltage to control pin. And I will set my multimeter to measure the frequency. In Hertz mode, frequency mode, I will connect the black lead to this positive terminal. And red lead, the positive lead, to the drain pin. We will take the signal from this pin. I connected the multimeter across the resistor. And I will attach my oscilloscope as well. I will connect oscilloscope low side to the positive terminal of the battery and signal probe to the drain pin. And now I will connect multimeter low side to the ground pin and the positive lead to here. This time there is no signal. Now I am increasing the voltage at control pin. At 4 volt there is nothing. We can see when the supply reached at 5 volt this multimeter is showing 107 kilohertz and here is 98 kilohertz. Now it will maintain the frequency until 5.7 volt. At 5.7 volt we can see it dropped its frequency. From 5.7 less than 4.7 volt it will work normally. No frequency here, no frequency here. In this way we can test the IC. 4.9 volt this IC is not working. Now this IC is off. Now I am increasing the voltage again. When it will exceed from 5 volt that is its threshold, 5.7 it started again. When the voltage will increase at that time it will turn off. Why? To reduce the magnetic field in the primary winding. When it will skip the cycle, switching cycle, at that time it will allow to maintain the voltage again. it will work in this way. It is offline switcher. When the voltage will remain maintained within this window from 4.7 to 5.7, at that time this IC will maintain its switching frequency at 100 kHz. The oscilloscope is displaying 98 kHz and this multimeter is showing 100 kHz. Let me check with this multimeter. Yes, this multimeter is also showing 96 kHz. And if I will check with this multimeter, yes, it is giving 96.5 kHz. That's good. So we can check frequency using multimeters. If you have this IC and it is not starting switching, so it is a best way to apply 5.5 volt here at control pin. At that time you can apply 5.5 volt 5 volt to 5.5 volt variable voltage, and you can monitor the switching cycle. If this IC is working, then you have to troubleshoot the other circuit for the power supply, because the auxiliary winding voltage are being controlled from the optocoupler. If we have something wrong with the IC, most of the time the optocoupler is damaged, the output transistor is damaged. When this transistor becomes short circuit, most of the time its output circuit becomes short circuit. When it is short circuit, at that time it will apply maximum voltage. The IC will turn on by this voltage, immediately it will turn off. Why? Because it will receive over voltage. When it will receive over voltage, then its required voltage, that are 5.7 volt, if the transistor is bad, we can see the IC will turn off. It will wait until the voltage are dropped again and capacitor will charge again, then it will start its switching cycle. When the IC will receive more voltage, at that time it will wait until the capacitor is discharged up to a specific level, and then it will start switching again when the voltage level will be maintained again. So voltage between 4.7 to 5.7 must be maintained at this point. So you can provide 5.7 volt, 5 to 5.7 volt to turn on this IC externally, as I applied voltage here at this pin. I hope so you enjoyed this video. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.